All right. So, this week's topic is the five worst mothering moments in musical theater. And I would do the five worst mothers, but they aren't all like horrible mothers. They just some of them just have bad moments. So the first one on the list is from Blood Brothers. Now here's the thing. She has like six kids or something, and then gets pregnant and finds out she's having twins. And she's like, "Well, I could afford one, but not two. So this woman that I work for will just pretend like she's pregnant too, and then we'll give one to her. And then they do it in secret so no one knows." And then the woman that she works for is like, "Well, you know, we can't tell anyone because of the whole prophecy or whatever that if twins are separated at birth in secret, that the day that they find out, they'll both die." So she knows this and still says this to her son.
Mickey, don't shoot Eddie. He's your brother. You had a twin brother. I couldn't afford to keep both of you. His mother couldn't have kids.
The one thing that's gonna kill him, that she knows for sure will kill him, is telling him that he had a twin brother. So what does she do? Says, "Don't kill him. He's your brother. You had a twin brother." And then, has the gall to say this. Tell me it's not true. Of course it is. You knew it was gonna happen. And they're both dead now. I don't feel bad for you at all. Okay, so actually, I love Blood Brothers, and I'm still waiting for someone in town to do that. And then, I think one of my favorite mothers in musical theater is the mom from Prodigal, which is one of my all-time favorite shows, but no one really knows it. I mean, no one knows the show. People know I like it. And the thing is that the mom has like this awesome moment after, because the son's gay, and so there's this song when they find out about it that the dad and the mom and the brother are like, "No, it's wrong," and she's like, "That's not my son. He's all confused," and you know, so like they deal with it. But then they get to this point, where like the son disrespects his dad or something, and they're from Australia, which is why he says the cheek. But then they say this, and she has this awesome moment where she totally sticks up for him.
"The cheek! I'd have walloped him from here to Sunday."
"I'm going outside and bringing him back."
"Don't you dare, Celia."
"Ordering me, Harry."
"I am telling you that if that person comes back into my house—"
"That person, is that who he's become? Not so long ago, he was your boy. That person, no, not even a name. Just heap him with blame, Harry. Try to destroy—"
"You heard what he said, Celia. He has shown me no respect."
"Have you shown him any—"
"Look at him!"
"If you mean he's made a mistake, that's pretty clear. But I'm sure he knows that more than you. If you mean he is a mistake, get out of here. I don't want to hear words so untrue. I'll not hear judgment till it's due."
So she totally stands up for him and says, you know, like, "If you think that our child is a mistake, get out of my house," basically. But then the next song in the show, she goes to her son and says this.
"I understand it's not the ideal solution. But is it so hard to keep quiet for a bit? Why make trouble?"
So she basically tells him to just keep quiet about it. Like, "I'm okay with it, but let's just keep that on the DL for a little bit here." Like, really? Come on. Come on, Mom. So then we get to Into the Woods because locking your daughter in a tower is always a good thing.
children should listen.
No, no, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see.
No.
And learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen.
So then she banishes her, like, into a desert. But then she gets what's coming to her because she's crushed by a giant. So it's like, okay. But Bernadette Peters, you're like, hey, we still love you. But speaking of Bernadette Peters, so your daughter runs off, but you still have this other daughter that you totally ignored for years. And then all of a sudden, so that you can still do what you want to do.
I'm gonna make you a star. I'm gonna build a whole new act all around you. It's going to be better than anything we ever did before. Better than anything we even dreamed. Look at the new star, Herbie. She's going to be beautiful. She is beautiful. Finished. We're just beginning. And there's no stopping us this time. I had a dream about you, baby. It's gonna come true, baby. They think that we're through, but baby.
I just always, like, the first time I saw that show, I was like, oh, but then the more you realize it, like, that's a really creepy moment of her. Because she literally said she's going to be beautiful, and then she's like, oh, wait, I should probably be nice. She is beautiful. Because it literally, like, it takes her no time to decide to do this. It's just like, well, one ran off, so it's your turn now. Because I'm going to make it happen. And then she doesn't want to do it. And then she literally forces her daughter to become a stripper. Okay, so now we get to the best mothering moment ever. And by best, I mean absolute worst. So, Carrie comes home from school and says to her mother,
something happened at school today, Mama. Something terrible. Terrible things are the Lord's way of testing us, Carrie.
I know. Mama, in the showers, the other girls...
You were forbidden to shower with the other girls.
I know,
forbidden.
I started to bleed.
When God made Eve from Adam's rib, and Eve was weak.
Mama.
And Eve was weak.
How could
and
I
Eve
know?
Eve was weak.
Why didn't
and
you
God
tell me?
To bear the curse of blood.
It's not a curse, Mama.
The curse of blood.
It's something all girls
the
go through.
The curse of blood.
You should have told me.
Go to the cellar and pray, woman. Pray to heaven for your wicked soul.
So she slaps her and tells her to go to the cellar. And literally, like, the song gets to this point where she's like, pray for he will burn you. And, is telling her daughter that because she has a period, she's basically going to hell. And then later that night, Carrie is saying her prayers in the cellar, and she comes out because her mom tells her that she can. And I think that these lines are great here.
I never wanted to cause you such pain, but there are times when life is so frightening. Maybe I do things that I can't explain, but my feelings for you never change.
I love that she basically asks for her forgiveness and says that she would rather die than watch her suffer, but she's the one who's slapping her child around, pulling her by the hair, and shoving her into a cellar. I love Carrie the Musical. And those are the top five worst mothering moments of musical theater.